Welcome to Buy Now, Sell Now. Let's go across to the Emphasis Management in conversation with ET now.
I think, given that we are now entering a new financial year, we've obviously focused on expanding our order book and our deal flow. And if I kind of go segment by segment, I think we still feel good about a few things that have happened positively in our direct core segment. So clearly our strategic accounts have grown well. We've also started to find good traction within our Blackstone portfolio. Right? So that was one premise that we went in with, and we spent a good amount of time over the last 90 days in making that happen. And I think we are also starting to focus a little bit more on go-to-market with new clients. So I think overall that segment should continue to grow at or above market is kind of the forecast that we're looking at. That's the premise for the last 3 years as well. From a growth within HP, I think this year should be our growth year for HP as well, mm-hmm. which is a major achievement if you're able to do it, because it's been a pretty tepid mm-hmm. negative growth segment for a number of years. From a segment perspective, I think things are, I would say, fairly stable. Obviously, shifts and spends have moved around within banking, from focuses a lot more on adoption of client-facing tech, contactless UI, application of things like blockchain and robo-advice, and a little less focuses on core systems or big bang approaches, because I think risk return reward wise, I think people are focused a lot more on this front end driven transformation. Right. So that, I think things are fairly stable in banking. I think insurance kind of goes up and down, depends on which segment of insurance and which part of the world. But I think things seem stable.
All right. I'll come to the HP side of the business in a while. But so bringing you in, as far as deal wins are concerned and the direct international side of the business, they have been quite positive. How do you see the order book really stacking up going ahead, in terms of client conversations, where do they stand?
Sure. As we mentioned that we had a 21% growth in the deal wins in FY17 over FY16, and that is also supported by a good pipeline, and we are very confident of a good revenue growth in direct international in FY18.
Alright. I wanted to elaborate a little more on the HP side of the business, because I think the last quarter was the first time that sequentially after 20 straight quarters that you did sort of see a sequential growth. How do you see that panning out over the next four quarters? And also, in your management commentary, you have mentioned about the advantage that the Bluestone portfolio of companies will bring. Would you sort of elaborate on, what synergies are you working at? Would it really drive to some extent of growth in the next four quarters?
Sure. I think, so there are two parts to your question. First was HP. Clearly, we put an underline within the HP relationship with the change in ownership and the MRC and the contract. So FY17 was all about stabilization, arresting the fall of revenue, and I think we demonstrated that through the year. In fact, we even had sequential growth, in a couple of quarters. I think FY18 is really about a turnaround from a growth point of view. So we do expect that segment to turn into a growth segment this year. And that's going to be driven by three core things. First, obviously, we've stabilized and we now have a good pipeline of core IT services. Second, we just announced a partnership this morning, and we expect that to start contributing as well in FY18. And I think that's a very significant new positioning for us, because we are now, positioning ourselves to be at the front end of transformation deals. Capabilities around cloud and cognitive are going to be very key for that. And thirdly, HP in itself is now not just one block, but there are four underlying entities that I talked about. So I think that gives us the opportunity to mine for relationships and find growth. On the, also asking me a question about the Blackstone portfolio. So I think we started a major initiative, I would say about 4 months ago, and we made very good progress. I think we did have one closure in Q4, but subsequent to that also we had a few more. So we do expect the Blackstone portfolio to start contributing to growth in the second half of FY18 as well.
Also, as far as the direct true revenues are concerned, about 10% plus or minus the currency fluctuation that we've seen, can we anticipate a double-digit sort of a growth in FY18 from the segment?
Yes, based on the pipeline which we have and the good traction we are having, I think we are quite confident of a double-digit growth in FY18 for direct core.
I'll just have another backup question to it. As far as cash allocation policy is concerned, under the new promoters, shareholders have got sort of a bumper offer, a dividend and a buyback. What's really left on the books right now, and what would the allocation policy turn out to be?
I think it would continue to be in the similar grounds, we will continue to give dividends in the stated, what our trend we have been doing for the last few years. And That's the policy will continue.
Okay. Lastly, you know, I was discussing this with you before we started the interview. The U.S. market and the noise that did, have you seen things settling down from an emphasis point of view? You know, will you have to sort of ramp up a bit of an investment there in terms of delivery centers and training employees and hiring more locally? What's really happening on that front?
You know, we've actually had a pretty good multi-channel diverse workforce capability for a number of years, and obviously our lineage and our history with being part of a large global U.S. tech company also helped. So from our perspective, I think we've constantly looked at how can we adjust our sourcing and our channels and our supply chain. I think there's no major changes and shifts that we need to make yet. We've done a few scenario planning and analysis, and I think we're ready for any eventuality. But so far, I think it's pretty stable for us.
All right, that's Emphasis, the management in conversation with ET Now's Rahul Dayama. It's been an okay set of numbers, but yes, the company has said that they have focused on expanding the order book as well as the deal flow. They are seeing good traction in the Blackstone portfolio, and they believe that FY18, it will post a turnaround year, at least from the HP side, and confident of good growth in direct international in FY18. But let's move on then to the management of LT Foods. Remember that that company as well delivered its Q4 numbers. It's been a decent set of numbers, a good 19.5% top line growth, net profit.